Right, Chase, 450 rookie debuts out of the way. Are you happy with how it went?
Yeah, I mean, relatively happy. I mean, I showed really good speed like I wanted to. I qualified first moto, came from 11th to 3rd in like two laps, passed a lot of good guys, and then kind of settled in behind Cooper, and that's kind of, I feel like, where my mistakes started happening and ended up going down. And I think I fell four more times after that or something like that. So first moto was a little bit of a bummer, but I still showed that I had good speed. And then second moto, got a good start. Kind of put a good ride in at the beginning, then chilled and got passed by a few people in the middle, and then made another charge and got back Muskan and Anderson and ended up third. So overall, I mean, getting on the podium for in a moto for my first race was really good and exceeded where I really wanted to be. I wanted to be like top five in a moto would have been really good for me, but overall top 10 was the goal. So I just wanted to go out and show that I had the speed and kind of earn the 450 guys' respect a little bit, which I feel like I've kind of did. I mean, they probably think I'm a little one-hit wonder, but I guess we'll see this weekend.
How was the pole position? I mean, did you come back in and feel like turned an awesome lap in? Or?
Honestly, like, my lap wasn't that good. I mean, I made a few mistakes, and overall, I felt like getting out front helped me a lot, and just kind of, I raced the first couple laps, and that's when I did my best lap. So, yeah, it was good. I felt nice to have fastest lap in my first race, and yeah, it was definitely exciting, but overall, the motos is where it counts, so.
So the crash that took you out of the lead pack in the first moto is just the rut, huh?
Yeah, I was struggling a little bit with bike setup all day, and then once that happened, I'm like, oh, I was kind of struggling a little bit to find my where the front wheel was a little bit all over the track, and I landed that little single, and my front end went in another rut, and my rear was in a different one, so ended up going down, and yeah, after that, the wheels kind of came off. But second motorway, made a few changes with the bike, and overall felt a lot more comfortable, and I think it showed.
So we'd heard rumors all along, like especially during the quarantine, early quarantine days, about how fast you were going on the 450. I guess they weren't rumors. They're true.
Yeah, I mean, you can only take so much from practice, and I felt really good, and obviously I still feel really good, but yeah, I knew my speed was going to be, I knew it was going to be where that I needed it, but I knew I had to be consistent, and these guys race a little bit different, so I'm pretty pleased with how my racecraft was last weekend. I learned a lot, like from first to second moto, I learned a little bit how the guys race, and I think translating my speed now into like more consistent laps and just being a little bit more solid, I think I can potentially win races and a lot of motos. So gonna try and keep building and just overall learn for next year's Supercross.
Yeah. Do you feel like the 450 suits you, the riding style you've got?
Yeah, I mean, ever since I was on Super Minis, I was like, the 250 suits my riding style. Then I got even bigger, and then I'm like, oh, okay, the 450 probably suits me better. So I had a 450 when I was, I think 2018 was the first time I ever got one on one when I was, I think I was 18 years old. And I automatically took to it, and I really liked it. And then I think that's when Honda kind of saw that I had potential on the bigger bike. And after last year's Supercross, I ended up riding at Glen Helen on Cole's race bike, and they thought I was going pretty fast. So that's kind of when the talk started happening. And then after Daytona, or it might have been after Atlanta, they came in to test before Daytona, and I felt really good on the bike, and I think they were pretty impressed. So overall, I felt really good on it since I got on the factory bike. So I'm looking to keep building and get better.
With Kenny withdrawing and then bringing Christian up, you're suddenly thrust in the limelight as the dude on the team. Was there any extra pressure from that?
No, I think having Kenny out is obviously a bummer, and I would like him to be racing, but I think it's an easier transition for me to be able to kind of get my feet like settled into the team and kind of learn the ropes a little bit before he comes and kind of feel like I'm the guy right now. So it's nice, but again, I wish Kenny was racing, and it's going to be fun racing with him next year in Supercross.
Cool. Last question. You got a whole new look for the outdoors and the new team. It's kind of like cool because you're your own guy now. You're not like a team uniform.
Yeah. I'm with Alpine Star now for 20 or from here and I think 3 more years, so it's gonna be good. I've dreamt of wearing this gear since Adam used to wear it on 85s and even Jordan Bailey, and I always wanted it, but you could never get it because it was always in Europe. So ever since then, I've always wanted to wear it. And this has been in the works since, I think, December or so last year. And I got it done the Tuesday before Loretta. So definitely a dream come true. And I think everyone dug it at the race. And I'm super excited to be wearing it.
Yeah, it's head to toe. Like,
yeah, head to toe.
You only have one gear guy now, right?
Yeah. Yep. It's pretty easy now. I have like three sponsors, so it's pretty easy to list them all.
You don't have to forget anyone on the podium.
Yeah. No, I was actually like doing my Instagram post the other day. I was like, man, I really don't have that many sponsors now. I got like, I have like three of them. So, no, that's cool though.
Well, last question. I'm sorry. I'm lying. Are you still working with Stu?
Yeah. Yep. Stu's still a thing. He was supposed to come to the race last weekend, but his I think his kid got sick. So he was pretty nervous, but we'll definitely be seeing him at races here shortly. He's been really good, and I think my speed kind of, it's cool because he was super fast, and now I feel like he's taught me a lot of stuff, and now I feel like I have the speed to win. So, yeah, it's been really good, and I'm excited to keep working in the future.